We have a kid in Beaver Scouts, and tonight they're doing catapults. So I thought I'd build something to contribute to that. So when you step down on this pedal here, that lifts the far end of this arm and throws this thing like so. I don't really like how it ends up flipping upside down after every shot, so I added this rope in here so that when it tries to flip, it'll catch itself.
Excellent.
Okay, ready? Yeah, it doesn't fly as well as the potato.
Hey, I got the potato!
We already got one on here.
When is your shooting?
Oh, two of them? Oh yeah, okay, sure. Oh, one went past the driveway. After those first tests, I improved it a little bit. I put this piece of plywood at a downward slant so this arm can come down a bit further. And also made this arm a little bit thinner so that it can move more easily. So the scouting event was in a gym, so I didn't shoot any of the potatoes because they fly much further and they could make a bit of a splat when they hit. Instead, mostly just shot bags full of sawdust, which are quite harmless if they hit somebody, and they don't fly as far, so that was also good. Although I did shoot this Kinder Surprise capsule with a little bit of wood in it once, and that just hit the ceiling and hit the far wall straight away. But all the kids were very enthusiastic about it. They all wanted to take a turn jumping on the catapult and shooting something. I only had a couple of hours when I built this thing, so I didn't film it at the time, but let's talk more about this now. So this is the main pivot, and this is a piece of hardwood to be nice and strong. And I just cut that to an octagonal shape with a bandsaw, and then used my strip sander to sand that roughly round to fit inside of a 19mm hole. And it has lots of play so it can pivot very easily. And I put some solid bolt finish on there to allow it to slide more easily as it turns to get more range. And this block of hardwood, which kind of looks like a cleat for boating, is to hold the other end of the rope. I wasn't sure if it's going to go around this way or that way, but I ended up going this way. And then the rope is just tied to a knot right here. Goes through this board here, which gets stomped on, and that pulls on that really hard. I thought about making some kind of more of a hard linkage to go between here and here, but the rope was the quickest and easiest, and it adds a little bit of a fail-safe, because that rope, of course, can fail, but so far, with lots of kids jumping on it, it hasn't failed. And then this board is what activates the whole thing by kids jumping on it here. And I guess it can withstand basically bottoming out here before this goes off. I even added a block underneath here so that when this bottoms out, it has a bit more force. But the flexibility of this board is important. And I was expecting that board to possibly break, but so far it's withstood all the kids jumping on it. And as catapults go, I think this is fairly safe because it doesn't have a spring that needs to be wound up or a weight that needs to drop. Basically, the force just comes from the kids jumping on here, so it's never going to go off accidentally and hit somebody that way. The one danger is, of course, that this part here might hit somebody, so if they're standing in front of it, that's bad. Worse, possibly, if they're jumping too close to here, that this might hit their hands. So realistically, to make it safer, I could have put a guard here just to make sure their hands are out of the way. But so far, it's not been a problem. Now with your typical Roman catapult, you have an arm that comes up like that from a spring or whatever, and it typically hits something like this, and that very precisely controls where the projectile is released, which makes for greater accuracy. But the problem with that is, as it goes like this, basically you have this whole thing moving as fast as the projectile is going to move, and it hits something. And there's a huge amount of energy that needs to be absorbed, and that usually causes the catapult to gradually self-destruct. Whereas with this one, basically the rope that actually made it go, it just ends up pulling back on the rope as it keeps going down, which stops this thing rather gently, without a bang or anything like that. But that means the release of the projectile happens by centrifugal force, so as this is moving, this wants to go straight, and it kind of flies off the end. And this is curved this way to kind of keep it under a bit longer so it doesn't fly off too quickly. But depending on what I'm shooting, if it's a potato, that tends to roll off the end rather quickly, whereas this bag tends to stay on a bit longer. And if it's something like a little block of wood like this, that can get hung up on there and actually shoot right into the ground. And just yesterday we had a birthday party and I set the thing up and it was a big hit with the kids, especially the bigger boys. And it's one of those toys that is just unsafe enough to make it exciting, but also unsafe enough that you can never buy one in a store. But if you want to build your own, here's a ruler for scale to get you a sense of it. And maybe I'll make plans for it. Let me know if you'd be interested in buying plans for this sort of thing.